Good morning, students. Myself, Nagmani Tiwari, your social science teacher. And today, we are going to study chapter number 3, Government. Now, in this chapter, we are going to deal with the meaning of government, functions of the government, importance of the government, and the government at different levels, the government and the law, and the organs of the government. So, all in all, we have to deal with the government. Now let us start with the meaning of government. The government is like a managing committee. It is a group of people who are elected by the people to rule over the nation. And we all know and we are very much familiar with this word, that is government. We daily hear in newspapers, radio, television, that the government has taken certain decisions, it has made certain rules and regulations, and there are some policies which are being finalized by the government for the welfare of the people. So let us study the functions of the government, in which we have the social, economic and political functions. Now the government in a democratic country basically functions as per the hopes and aspirations of the people. It took several steps for the economic and social development of the nation. It also solves many social and economic problems like poverty, unemployment, illiteracy, healthcare and medical facilities. It also takes certain decisions which are political. Like it maintains friendly relations with other nations of the world in order to protect the geographical boundary of our nation. It also provides low price food grains to the poor people. It also gives certain facilities to us like educational institutions, government hospitals, primary healthcare facilities. So all these are the functions of the government. Now what is its importance? Now the government, as we know, it makes laws, and it is the responsibility of the government to ensure that it is equal for all the people. One of the main function or importance of the government is to make rules and regulations whenever there is a public gathering or social and religious functions are there. The government importance is much more in that case, because it has to deal with a very critical situation whenever there is natural disasters. At that time also, government provides assistance to the people who are affected by natural calamities. So this is the importance of government. Now the fourth one, that is government at different levels. Since India is a vast country, so the government, for the administrative efficiency and effectiveness, functions at three different levels, that is national level, state level and local level. Now the national level government deals with the affairs or the matters of the whole nation, while the state level, it deals with the matters of a particular state. And the third one, that is local level, it deals with the matters and the problems related to villages, towns and city areas. Now government and the law, as we all know, it is given in our constitution that a country needs a government in order to make a law. So the government makes certain law which has to be abided by the people of the nation, otherwise they will be punishable by the judiciary. If they break the law that is framed by the government, it is a punishable offense, and they can be fined or also they can be jailed. Now the last one, that is organs of the government. Now as we know, there are three organs of the government: legislature, executive and judiciary. The work of the legislature is to make law, and that law has to be implemented by or executed by the judiciary, and the third one, that by the executive, and the third one, that is judiciary, it makes the people to follow the rules, and those who do not abide by the rule, they are punishable by the judiciary. So this is some of the information related to government, in which we have studied the meaning of government, functions of the government, importance of the government, government at different levels, that is national, state and local level, the government and the law, and the organs of the government, that is legislature, executive and judiciary. So in the next class we'll study chapter number 4. Thank you.